All right, so Ike is for the most part pretty simple. Oh no, I already did Ike. What the hell am I talking about? It can't be Ike. The one thing I will say is they did make him heavier. That's definitely, I can feel it. Not Ike. Who was it? Was it Game and Watch? As you can see, he only has different color palettes for his outfits. Alright, so for Game & Watch, as you can see, he only has a couple frames of animation for most of his stuff. He has an infinite, which also has a finisher. Yep, see? He hits him with a chair for his light side, a flag that hits multiple times for his... But look at this. He has a flag that hits multiple times for his uppercut. He flips a manhole, but it'll miss if you're right next to him, see? If I can walk on the other, nearly to the other side of her and miss, it was missing a second ago. His smash, fire. Puts on a diving helmet for his up smash. He hits on both sides for his down smash, which is pretty helpful. What else? His aerials, fish out of water. The fish kind of arc out and will hit people. He has, I was never sure what the hell this is. I guess it's a box. He hits people with like a box, a jewelry box or something. I have no clue what the hell that was supposed to be, even as a kid. He hits him with a turtle when he flies backwards. Although sometimes the problem with Game & Watch is it's hard to really see what direction he's actually facing. Because sometimes he'll, like, turn around in midair and do weird stuff, and it's kind of hard to know. It's like if you're trying to say, okay, I want to face this way and I want to back attack, it might be hard to make him come out. That's just me. If you play with him, you'll probably get used to it, and you'll probably be able to tell what his moves are like. Up, he turns into a chimney, I guess. I have no clue. This key has downward thrust. I don't know if it always had that, but it does now, if it doesn't. His throws, basically he juggles them one way or the other. All, it's just the same animation, just a different launcher. That was the down throw, by the way. That was weird. I guess you can kind of see how it's the down throw. See, by the distance launched, although there really doesn't appear to be much of a difference. Now, his basic B move throws a bunch of item or a bunch of cooking items at people. As you can see, there's more items initially, and then it slows down a bit. And they'll hurt people. His side B is weird. There was an event match I did yesterday that really showed it off. Whoops, that's not his side B. Let me KO Zelda just so I can show it to you fresh. Come on. That's his dash move, by the way. He trips. Alright, so for his side B, it will randomly determine a number, and each number from 1 to 9 has a different effect. So as you can see, 8 will freeze someone, 5 will shock them, 6 will put them on fire, 1 will actually do nothing, I believe, or damage Game & Watch. Shit, I don't want to do this. 4 just knocks him back. 3 switches with him. See, it knocks him that way. 2 does nothing. It's just a basic attack. 3. See if I can get 9 to come out. Oh, sweet. I did not know 7 would heal you. If 9, 7 launches and drops an apple. Cool. That's cool that some of the characters can heal themselves in minor ways like that. 8. See, because I think 9 is very hard to make come out. I'm getting 8 a lot. Hey, oh, that was 6, I think. Eight. 3. Oh my, of course. I think 9 is a launcher that will pretty much try to kill someone. Let me see if I can get it again really quickly. There you go. 9 will KO someone, but again, it's random, so it's unpredictable. Now, this move is actually, he'll hold out a bucket, and any energy moves, kind of like what Ness does, will be absorbed, and he can hold it, he can tilt, and once it gets high enough, you can shoot it back at people. And finally, his recovery is a parachute, and he has people come out and bounce him up, so it's all right. And pressing down will close the parachute. Alright, so let's see his finisher. Is it the octopus? Yeah, basically he turns into an octopus. Really, really fucking creepy. And you can die from it too. So that's why I never really used it. So I don't really know too much about it. But Game & Watch isn't too bad. You know, he's just not my type of character. Well, I can kind of see what you would want to do with him. Basically, you're going to want to combo that like all the other combos until they're getting far away. And then do the finisher. Like that. So that way you get all the hits and you knock them back so they don't immediately retaliate. Alright, and that is going to be it. That was an hour and a half of trying out different characters. And seeing what all their special things were, and there's still more to do. So maybe next time, maybe like one or two more sessions, and I'll hit all the characters. All right, that's pretty good.